All right, next we will hear from teaching elder Julie Hawkins, the chair of our Standing Committee on World Outreach.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Would you join me in prayer? Father God, we lift you up as the Lord of all creation. And as we hear this report from World Outreach, we're reminded that you are the God of every nation. Would we be encouraged by stories of people who are taking out the Great Commission, that they are making disciples throughout all the world? Would we be challenged to be a denomination that continues to do that great work? And would we go out rejoicing in the work that you are doing through our denomination? And we pray these things in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. And now I'd like to hand over the mic to ruling elder Gabriel de Guia, who is the EPC's Executive Director of World Outreach.
Thank you, Madam Chair. On behalf of the World Outreach Committee, it is my pleasure to bring this report. The committee has no recommendations for consideration for this assembly to vote upon, so my time up here might resemble more closely to an Academy Awards thank you speech, which is appropriate because there's a tremendous amount to be thankful for. And I have to begin that thanks for per member asking slash percentage of income that allows us to do what we do. And we can only do that together. You have access to the report, which highlights 9 areas of accomplishment this past year, but I'd like to provide more detail in 3 areas which are not found in that report. First, personnel. Since the beginning of World Outreach, the Lord has always provided strong leadership to support at every time and stage of the ministry. Whenever the Lord has led people to move on from World Outreach, He has provided the right people to step in where others have left off in order to help lead into the next chapter. At the end of last year, God called our previous office staff, all of them except me, to step into His next call in their professional lives, which was very exciting. We celebrated with them. But praying for who would follow in their footsteps, who served so well before them, God answered in bringing our new World Outreach office team members. Dean mentioned in his report that 19 of the OGA staff, 4 of them, are with World Outreach. I'm one of them, and I'm grateful for the 3 God has brought onto our team, and I'd like to introduce you to them as they stand now. This is Carla Cora, Torres Kearney, and Jordan Greer. Carla is our new financial analyst. Torres is my executive assistant, and our new assistant director of World Outreach, the Reverend Jordan Greer, whose last name will change on October 7th when she gets married. The IDRF, the International Disaster Relief Fund, created just about a year and a half ago to enable the EPC to respond to international crisis, has provided life-saving resources in a multitude of ways by bringing relief and ministry efforts to ravaged locations. In the last year, we've distributed $523,201 through World Outreach direct workers and partners on location to help people in crisis, bringing relief and gospel work and word and deed, specifically in Ukraine, Poland, Pakistan, Turkey, Syria, and Sierra Leone. In my hand here, I hold our new annual report, reflecting some of the things that God has done in this last year. And on page 6 of this report, which some of you may have, there are a set of numbers. And I would like to say that these numbers do not tell the story. They only scratch the surface of starting the story. One of these numbers is under I-10. It says 679, which reflects 679 students enrolled through I-10, the International Theological Education Network, training sites. You heard from Mike Kuhn the other night that he and I traveled to Southeast Asia to just one of these 10 sites to visit with 30 of these 679 students. What you don't see in this number are those 30 students who finished and completed their certification have trained 500 plus other people, church leaders, impacting over 270 other churches. That's not reflected here. The numbers don't tell that story. Another number, 146 commissioned workers with EPCWO. Well, that number's already outdated. Two nights ago, we commissioned 13 more. That's now 159. So praise God for what he is doing. Another number here is how many engaged 2025 church planting teams have been initiated among unreached people groups, UPGs. It says 9 here. It's actually 10. And let me tell you about one of those 10. One exists in the country of Pakistan, and that work from the outside looking in might not look like church planting, because it looks a lot like an athletic ministry, because that's what it is. It's a cricket club. But what is that cricket club? It's actually in 16 different locations, led by 16 men who have amazing stories, who love God, who are being trained, have been trained, continue to be trained, have been discipled, continue to be discipled. They look like coaches, but in essence, they are church pastors planting churches under the title and reality of cricket clubs. They do play cricket. They are cricket clubs. They play cricket every day. But also every day, they do inductive Bible studies. They pray, and they're being trained in life skills. They're amazing people, and they're being discipled and trained by one of our own. I'd like to introduce you to one of these amazing people by way of video right now.
Pakistan, a country where some 98% of the population are not followers of Jesus, 100% are devoted followers of cricket. A rising Pakistani cricket player, Asaf Din, recognized the influence of cricket and began a network of cricket clubs to train young people to excel at the sport while introducing them to Jesus and discipling them as his followers. The Serve clubs have attracted top national players such as Vicky.
Ji dosto cricket jehdi hai main yani bachpan to khelda aaya lekin khuda da shukr te khuda da fazl hai vi khuda ne bahut ghat arse de vich choti umar ch khuda ne fazl bakhsha ki main achhi cricket khel saka te khuda ne fazl bakhsha aur us to baad jehda Pakistan di sab to main trophy yani Qaiz-e Azam trophy region level kafi level tak khuda ne mainu cricket khilai hai khudawand di shukr guzari hai.
Although Vicky was gaining success and fame on the cricket pitch, there was a growing emptiness in his life. But through the ministry of the Serve Pakistan cricket clubs, that void was filled when he became a true follower of Jesus.
Cricket de vich badi tarakki mili lekin meri zindagi de vich ik khalas si jehde khalas nu khuda ne 2016 de vich jadon main camp da hissa baneya khuda ne apna mukashfa jehda mere te zahir kita.
Now, Vicky is committed to spreading the good news of the gospel using the national sport of cricket as his platform.
ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਨਾ ਕ੍ਰਿਕਟ ਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਨਾ ਉਹ ਕਹਿ ਲਓ ਵੀ ਹਰ ਉਹ ਮਾਸ਼ਰੇ ਦੇ ਬੰਦੇ ਨੂੰ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਨਾ ਇਹ ਇਕੱਠਾ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਦੂਸਰਾ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਇਹਦਾ ਪਲੇਅਰ ਦੀ ਉਹ ਤਰੱਕੀ ਦੇ ਉਹ ਦਰਵਾਜ਼ੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਮੁਮਕਿਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਉਹ ਇਸ ਕ੍ਰਿਕਟ ਦੇ ਜ਼ਰੀਏ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖੁੱਲ੍ਹਦੇ ਨੇ ਔਰ ਇਨਸਾਨ ਪਲੇਅਰ ਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਉਹ ਤਰੱਕੀ ਦਾ ਇਹ ਬਾਇਸ ਬਣਦੀ ਹੈ ਕਿਸੇ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ.
Today, Vicky is the leader of one of the Serve Pakistan cricket clubs and is dedicated to helping young people not only become great cricketers, but also become dedicated followers of Jesus Christ.
ਖੁਦਾ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਰੋਇਆ ਮੇਰੇ ਸਪੁਰਦ ਕੀਤੀ ਮੈਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਵਫਾਦਾਰੀ ਨਾਲ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਚੱਲ ਰਿਹਾ ਵਾਂ. ਇਸ ਰੋਇਆ ਦਾ ਹਿੱਸਾ ਬਣਨਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਾਡੇ ਲਈ ਉਹ ਸ਼ਰਫ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਵੀ ਸਾਡੀ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਭਾਈ ਆਸਫ ਦੀ ਜ਼ੇਰੇ ਸਰਪ੍ਰਸਤੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆ ਇਸ ਰੋਇਆ ਨੂੰ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਉਸ ਬੀਜ ਨੂੰ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਅੱਗੇ ਬੋਂਦੇ ਜਾਈਏ ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਆਉਣ ਵਾਲੀ ਨਸਲਾਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਬੀਜ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਉਹ ਜਾਰੀ ਸਾਰੀ ਰਹੇ.
So for some perspective, those 16 clubs include over 1,600 men in those clubs. And there are lots of clubs to choose from. And in this Muslim nation, they choose this club. All those guys who go to these clubs, they choose that because they see something that they want in the character and the skills that those players are gaining. They want that, and that's a fantastic witness. I want to personally thank our World Outreach Committee members who have been a great counsel of wisdom for me support and prayer and friendship, not just executing the business of this ministry, but being a great support to me. So I thank Doug Dempsey and Johnny Long, Wes Peterson, Dave Van Valkenburg, Whitney Alexander, Susan Lear, Marcus Ortega, Waring Porter, ex officio member and assistant World Outreach Director Jordan Greer, and our chairman, Rick Dietzman. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes in me will also do the works that I do, and greater works than these will he do. This is merely a faint glimpse at the eternal work we as EPC have been a part of this year in global movement. I thank you. We do all of this together.
Thank you, Gabriel and Mr. Moderator. That concludes our report.